Hola guys, welcome to my channel. And in this video, I'd be ranting about this Wi-Fi dongle we bought for my brother-in-law's computer. In my previous video, I talked about that. If you missed it, kindly check that out. And anyway, the motherboard we bought, it's a gaming computer, budget build, and the motherboard we bought for his computer doesn't come with a Wi-Fi pre-installed. You know, the built-in Wi-Fi some motherboard has. It doesn't come with that. So we decided to buy a dongle instead. We chose a USB dongle opposed to the PCIe add-in card network adapter, you know. Well, at the very least, a USB you can just disconnect it and use it somewhere else or with another computer. And this is really nice. It's this one here. It's a dual band USB adapter. Price in the description field below and where I bought it. I'm from the Philippines, for your information. And I bought it for 200 pesos. So it's a dual band USB adapter, 2.4 gigahertz and a 5 gigahertz band. And description field is here. And yeah, just pause the video if you need to read them. And here's the USB stick or Wi-Fi stick. It's here in this picture here. I placed the a ruler beside it for reference, and it's really small and compact. So in the package, it just comes with a CD. Well, if you read the data card, if you're on Windows Vista, you'd probably need this. And this USB stick, yeah, I've already shown it in the picture. The light right there in the middle, that's where the LED light is, I suppose. I haven't tried it still. It's Wi-Fi AC. It's in the description field, so basically it's Wi-Fi 5 and 2.4 and 5 gigahertz, so most probably an N band and an AC band. So it supports G and B as well. And yeah, let me just connect this and let's test this thing out. All right, so I've connected the dongle, no problem, really quickly. I connected. At first, I had a problem. Sorry, I did have a problem. I wasn't able to connect to the 2.4 gigahertz band of my router. My router is an AX11000 from ASUS, and it won't connect for some reason. 5 gigahertz band, no problem. 2.4, I wasn't able to connect. Restarted my modem, restarted the router, no problem now. It's connecting fine. It does have a problem connecting to hidden networks though. So if your router is configured to hide the network ID, be sure to disable that one, all right? And now I'm connected to the 2.4 gigahertz band. The router is 20 feet away with the one wall separating it from my room here. And my other network interface adapters are disabled. The pre-built Wi-Fi adapter is disabled, the one from Intel AX201. My motherboard is an ASUS TUF Z690 motherboard. And my iPhone's connected here as well, but it's disabled. And Ethernet cable is disabled also, all right? Only one running is the dongle connected to a 2.4 gigahertz band. Now let's check on the status first before we start. The speed's being shown 72.2 Mbps. And by the way, benchmarking results will be shown at the end of this video. Timestamped here. Feel free to skip ahead if you're just interested in the numbers, all right? 72.2 Mbps. Now let's start the. I'll change the server first. Let's choose Converge. I'm near Pasig, so let's use this one here. And let's start the testing. This is actually pretty low. This is actually pretty low, but you have to understand the router is a room away. This thing doesn't have any antennas on it, and I really think the wall is really affecting the, you know, the quality of the signal. Now let's try and connect my Wi-Fi that's pre-built into my motherboard. All right, so now I'm using my motherboard's pre-built Wi-Fi AX201. Let's check the speed first. Again, I'm connected to the 2.4 gigahertz band. Status, 144 megahertz or Mbps. But guys, this particular Wi-Fi adapter has antennas, so it's sticking out at the bottom of this table here. But having an antenna obviously affects performance, and let's start the testing. So that's the result there, and 69, hey, not bad opposed to the other values. I'd sum them all up after we test the results, all right? And those are the numbers there. Now let's start with 5 gigahertz band on. Now let's reconnect to the dongle and let's connect to the 5 gigahertz band and let's see how that performs. So the Wi-Fi dongle is now connected to the 5 gigahertz band. All right, Wi-Fi dongle connected to the 5 gigahertz band. Let's check the status first. The speed here is being shown, is showing 260 Mbps. Again, guys, if you could see the signal quality, it only has 4 bars. 5 is the max. This dongle doesn't have antennas. I cannot emphasize that enough, all right? Again, I have a wall dividing from this room to the next, and it doesn't have any antennas, and the integrity of the signal really affects the speed that's being shown here in the status page, all right? Now, and don't mind the speed. For some reason, I enabled the Ethernet speed, which reminds me my internet speed is 800 Mbps, all right? More on that later on in the conclusion. Let's carry on. So the speed is 154, 116, 72 Mbps for the upload. Not bad, not bad, considering it's a dongle with no antennas. And that's the score there. And let's disable this one, check the other one out. All right. Now my motherboard, my built-in Wi-Fi is connected to the 5 gigahertz band. Let's check the status first. The speed is being the speed's being shown showing 306 Mbps. Let's start the testing. Pretty impressive. Pretty impressive. Actually, this is my third take. My first take, my HDR of my monitor is turned on. I had to redo it. The color's all blurry. And the next one is the values you've shown. For some reason, I accidentally enabled Ethernet, so I had to redo that. And finally, we were able to finish things. But what I decided on doing is include another test where I'd be connecting them to my iPad hotspot, you know. This has a 5G. This has 5G connection. This has 5G connection. I will make a test. I'll run a speed test here and do a screenshot. And here's the result of it. So I'm able to find it's done. I just had to change the server. I switched the server to smart communications instead using the 5G connection of this iPad. Now the hotspot is on. I was able to get 191. It did hit 200, 210 for a short time. All right. For a short time. And it stabilized at 191. And the upload is 35.3. Now let's work with this one here. I actually tried to run this test already, but it was really low. Starting with the iPad, I had to confirm with this one here. It was really low with the Converge server, so I had to transfer to Smart Communication. And let's start with a Wi-Fi dongle first. Let's check the status. 390 Mbps, 433. But to be fair, the iPad is right here. It's right next to it. The dongle is actually able to hit the declared performance value there, so that's a good sign, right? And let's start the testing. Smart Communications, pretty impressive, pretty impressive. I was able to get 190 Mbps earlier in the first run. because it was in Converge, it was really getting low scores for all devices. I switched to Smart. I was able to hit 200 Mbps earlier with a dongle, but right now it's stabilized at 178. But it's really raining hard outside, so performance may actually vary there because of the weather. So here's the result there, and let's try the next one. All right, so Wi-Fi, built-in Wi-Fi on the motherboard connected to the hotspot. Let's check the status real quick. 1.1 gigabits per second, but to be fair, it's pretty near. And this built-in Wi-Fi is not limited to the 433 megabits per second. This one actually has Wi-Fi 6, same as the iPad does. All right. So let's check the test, or let's start the test. Pretty impressive. Pretty impressive. There you go. But to be fair, again, guys, it's on Wi-Fi 6. That may be the reason why it's a bit higher. But weather is out. It's really raining hard out. Anyway, here are the benchmarking result or test results here. So those are the results. As you can see, the Wi-Fi 6 beats Wi-Fi 5. No doubt about that. But to be fair, this dongle was able to hold itself up. And what I couldn't recommend is if your situation is similar to mine, where the router is in the next room with a wall separating them, this won't be a good idea, guys. If the router is right next to your computer, that happens. If especially if you just don't want some wire runs or wire clutters inside your room, this will become pretty handy. And for 200 pesos, it's not pretty bad. And if your internet speed is greater than 100 Mbps, make sure your router has 5 GHz band, so that you won't be too impacted, or the degradation of your internet speed won't be that noticeable. 5 GHz band, this one is able to hold up at the very least, right? Again, there's no antenna. It's really small. It gets pretty warm. It gets pretty warm, actually. I just held it earlier. And other than that, if your USB are pretty close together, this will become important. So far so good. Again, guys, emphasis on the router being next to this thing, all right? If it's too far away, you might hate your budget build computer. That's all I'm trying to say. Maybe it'll be a better option if you buy a network interface card, a Wi-Fi, PCIe, where you connect them to the PCIe slot of the motherboard. Assuming that you'd have an extra slot, all right? So if you'd have that option, maybe use that one, but it's a bit expensive, somewhere in the 1,000, 900, between 900 and 1,500 pesos, somewhere in that range. Otherwise, buy a USB Wi-Fi adapter that has antenna. That would be a better option, in my opinion, if the router is far away. That's it for this video. I hope I was able to help someone out, especially for those deciding on if they'd be purchasing this one. Again, I hope you enjoyed. See you in the next one.